Office of Director of Public Prosecution. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Karim.
My Lord Justice Mugoli, Chair of the Judiciary Committee on Elections, the Inspector General, the Chairperson of the IEBC, the Chairperson of the NCIC, the Chairperson of IPOA, the Registrar of Political Parties, the Country Director of UNDP, Amanda Serumanga, the DCI, Development Partners, Civil Society Representatives, representative from the media who are main stakeholders, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here on behalf of the Director of Public Prosecutions, who could not make it because of other assignments, but he sends his regards. The Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions is honored to be a principal partner in the development of these guidelines. We are also delighted to be part of this lounge. Ladies and gentlemen, security is paramount to all citizens and should be perceived as a matter of right and not a privilege. For the country to have a free and fair, transparent and accountable and credible elections, security of the person, property and security of the environment are all prerequisites. The National Police Service is constitutionally mandated to uphold the rule of law and ensure security in all corners of this country. However, during this electioneering period, this is a shared responsibility for all law enforcement agencies. The Director of Public Prosecutions, in exercise of his mandate under Article 157 of the Constitution and Section 21 of the Election Offences Act, is committed to impartially prosecute all perpetrators of election violence, irrespective of party affiliations, political positions, gender, race, and creed. In realization of this shared responsibility, the Office of the Director of Public Prosecution, as you are aware, has established a team of 105 prosecutors strategically located throughout the country to prosecute election-related offenses. To this end, in the recently concluded party primaries, the DPP has and is prosecuting 31 election-related offenses involving 62 individuals. The offenses vary from assault, incitement to violence, malicious damage to property, just but to mention a few. The DPP has participated in the development of this security awareness program training material, and therefore we embrace them. In addition, the DPP undertakes to train other law enforcement officers in partnership with IEBC. Notably, ladies and gentlemen, ensuring security during this electioneering period will not be the preserve of IEBC and the National Police Service. It will be a multi-agency and stakeholder-owned and driven process. It is for this reason that the DPP assures all stakeholders in the administration of justice and the general public of his commitment and that of his officers towards the delivery of a free and fair, accountable, transparent, and credible elections. We undertake to ensure that in exercising our mandate, we will ensure there is a secure environment, and whoever will commit any offence will be brought to account in accordance with the Constitution and in upholding the rule of law. Ladies and gentlemen, being part of the people who developed these guidelines,